Yesterday I had 67 argon crystals. Today, 56. Already have Hildren. Don't need to build another one. And where is it? It's not gear. Miscellaneous. Yeah, I'm not putting four forma into an aura forma just yet. Or an Exilus adapter. Not just yet. I need a lot more forma before I do that. And as far as putting them into incubator power cores, I've got 44 power cores. And they cost 100,000 credits each to make. And I'm saving credits along with ducks for the Tenocon relay. DE, why did you increase the spawn rate for a resource that no one wants or can use a million of? Argon crystals, in this case, while when I go to farm for the mod card that I want to drop, coolant leak, let's see if I can spell it properly, coolant leak, it drops off orc and drones and spectators. It has a point. Not a 1 or 2%, a 0.02% drop rate. Which means I would have to, at the long end of the mathematics of it, I would have to destroy 10,000 just to get one drop. And I've been running through Mott and Annie. I'm gonna load up Annie right now. Little orphan Annie. Poor little bastard became Darth Vader. That's what happens when you don't have parents. You become a little orphan Anakin Skywalker and then you turn into Darth Vader. Just get Oliver twisted up into a really bad crowd.
Your job is to distract the enemy while a fellow Tenno operative raids the ship for much needed supplies.
Yeah, yeah, surprise.
Life support has been cut off.
Anyway,
they're trying to choke you out. Hold on.
Why did you make drop rate so infinitesimally small? And while we're talking about drop rates, I don't need to have any more than 10 argon crystals at once. They don't last. And unless you change that mechanic so that they do last, there's no reason to have their drop rate so exorbitant so that it gives you dozens of, literally dozens. And at this point, when I actually finish farming for Kuzumi, it will have been hundreds. Because their drop rate is unnecessarily high. The type of resource that it is. It's a resource that degrades and goes away. And if you go about altering the drop rate for the argon crystals, the only thing it will tell me is that you're doing what Torolf Jernstrom said to manipulate players into giving you money. My solution for that is simple. Tell Torfjernstrom to go fuck himself. And make sure that the drop rate for anything never is below 1%. And as far as, you know, giving the player more when they earn it through mastery rank and actually playing the game like you want them to, every mastery rank increase the percentage drop rate for everything across the board. Now, whether you go with 0.5% per mastery to, you know, at the total of mastery rank 30, giving you an extra 15% drop rate, or go with 1% so that it's 30% at mastery rank 30. That's your choice to make. But it would most definitely make mastery rank mean something, other than look how many toys I've played with in the game. Now the psychosomatics of the situation is, look at how many days I've spent playing. But essentially, 30 days is meaningless. If you want mastery rank to mean something, don't force people to spend more time playing. Give them the reward to decrease the amount of time they need to spend playing in order to acquire things in the game. Something else. When those Eximuses release that shockwave, it should diminish its effect over the duration that it travels. So that if you're far enough away, it doesn't affect you at all. I mean, you've given the player limitations for AoE. Where the fuck is the limitation on the game's enemies for AoE? Where's that balance? Where's that equitable balance? No, I'm not ready to extract. I still have to kill a few hundred million more of those Orican sentinels. That's not gonna stop me from going over and camping next to extraction, just in case. I didn't touch that. Oh, you cheeky, daft, adorable cunt. Get over here so I can kill you properly. There. Shade's stealth mod card that makes you invisible. It needs some range extension on it too. So, yeah, make another mod of it with extended range. Yeah, the ghost mod card. Why not make a prime ghost mod card? Or a rare one. Thing is, if you go with Prime, just make it to where it's always invisible. Listen, just stop grabbing me. Snipe by napalm on this Kuva Ogres is really something, isn't it? I've even taken it into mod.
We've got signals singing the same song as our victim. Careful now.
Yeah, I can't serve what, 30 minutes like that?
There's less than nothing left of who they once were.
Really nice.
But no glass is unbreakable.
Nora, I've beaten a lot of these. Just stop talking about it. Also, I wouldn't mind a Prime adaptation that provides 100% immunity to status procs with a much longer timer that can refresh. I'm thinking somewhere upwards of 2 minutes, along with up to about, I don't know, thinking somewhere around 80 or 90% damage reduction. Duration incorporates whatever status that you've got on the weapon into the DOT, the damage over time proc. That would be cool. You know, D, you can save those for hard mode and ultra hard mode if you want. Also, I seriously think you need to fix the grapple mechanics. I don't mind them grappling when I'm at 70 to 100% of their grapple range, but them doing it when I'm literally right in front of them has to stop. Granted, I'm convinced that you just copy and pasted that simple program script from the original Doom 1 and 2 games. I'm utterly convinced that that's exactly what you did. But it needs to be modified and adjusted to fit the situation. Having them just grapple you even when you're right in front of them, it's not just annoying, it's a bad game mechanic. It shows how mindless your so-called AI really is. Yeah, that was a jab. I'm gonna keep jabbing at Steve, because he's an idiot. Stop grappling me! Every fucking time! So fucking annoying. Yeah. That ties into another thing I've noticed. You wanted to make the Prime Sure-Footed mod card relevant. She made it to where everyone gets knocked on their ass a whole lot more. That just shows how lazy you are as programmers. That shows how little thought, care, devotion, and concern that you've put into this game recently. It may have started as a passion project, but as of recently, it's become a big fuck you, we just want money project.
Tenno operative just found. They could not do this without you.
And don't try and blame Microsoft for passing on rules and regulations. I already know that a lot of the game mechanics that don't have anything to do with microtransactions, they have nothing to say on the matter, so don't lie. All you'll succeed in doing is aggravating me and pissing off everyone else that you've already pissed off. See, right there, and it grapples. Literally, right in front of it. Not even a meter away in game space, and it grapples. Fix this. It's something you could hotfix in a matter of 15 minutes, even while working from home. Goddamn argon crystals I have to have use for. Well, I am getting a steady stream of them in this room. I think I'll just continue to camp in this one. Like I said before, D, don't nerf what the player's capable of. You're already gonna implement hard and ultra-hard mode. That'll be enough of a challenge. Then if your concern is players trivializing it, don't look at it that way. Look at it as what it really is. Players have achieved and accomplished a level of skill and power within the game. They have succeeded in becoming better players. That's something to be rewarded and encouraged. Like another video I said, it's a lot of setup, but making a so-called meta for literally everything in the game is something you want, because it allows everyone to choose, do I want to meta this weapon, use it because I like the way it looks, or do I want to play with something else and see what its meta is? Eventually, everybody's going to get around to doing both of those things. But you want that reward for the effort and the discovery to be there. Some YouTuber inevitably does share that so-called meta with everyone else. Let it happen. Just sharing their accomplishment with everyone else.
We will all share in this bounty. Hold out as long as you can.
But everyone else can enjoy it. You come up out of nowhere. It was you. Stupid Eximus. I get knocked back and he grapples me. Yeah, that's funny. I get a chuckle out of those every now and then. But most certainly not when I'm literally standing right in front of them and they grapple me. And in the game's coding, I'm fairly certain that that mechanic is still coded the exact same way that it was in the first and second Doom game, which is, what, 50 years old? But it still classes that mechanic of grappling as a ranged attack. There goes more fucking art. Hey. jumped up because I wanted to get up, not into the pool of water. Have an explodey bit to the face. Thinking I'm injecting my personal tastes and whatnot into what I'm saying. Here's my personal want on the matter of that grapple mechanic. My personal want is to remove it entirely.
The more successful we will be.
I do enjoy how powerful these cool weapons are. Don't ever nerf them. The second you do that, you diminish the value of even fighting the Lich to begin with. The only thing you have accomplished is pissing off everyone that plays the game. Well, that and revealing just how much of a manipulative twirl of your instrument some shit you really are. Goes for you too, Microsoft. I guess that gives new meaning to the phrase crotch rocket. Before I forget, I'm perfectly fine with nullifiers stopping the use of abilities while you're inside the bubble. What I'm not fine with is them canceling abilities that are currently active. Now between that and the truth that most shots from, well, a lot of weapons just bounce right off the nullifier shield. Now whether you did that to make that mod card for Hildren something or not is irrelevant. That would have been relevant. That mod card would have been relevant no matter what. I thoroughly plan on using both of those augments for Hildren. But you didn't have to make the enemies even more powerful just to make something you wanted to be relevant. That's not how things work. Just because you made that happen doesn't mean it's worth having that way.
Tenno operative just found. They could not do this.
Kinda like you inhibited everyone's pursuit of happiness. Just to modify Ember's radial AoE so that it had to be continuously recast and had a much shorter range. Just because you didn't like the way that other people chose to play the game, it's not your choice, D. It never was. The only thing you reveal is how much of a tyrant you are. Just how corrupt you truly are. Why, I think I'm done with this area for now. This isn't the first time I've gone for 30 minutes this mission to kill the Orican sentries to get coolant leak. The level of grind is absurd. Unwarranted, unprecedented, not equitable, and not fair. Not by any meaning of those terms. Not even equitable for Microsoft and DE to make money. Light, you little fuck! Cheeky little bastard didn't want to do its job. Like my lighter, when it doesn't light, I make effort to fix it so that it lights. So too with the gaming industry. The gaming industry's job is to support everyone's right and privilege. privilege to pursue their happiness. If you can't do your job, you don't deserve to be in that position to begin with. And you'll be replaced by someone who can and will. Time to go over here. I'll take care of two things in one go. I'll get some of those, well, one of those mod cards off of Mr. Half-Vor. I'll teabag him. And I'll keep working to take out Orc and sentries to get coolant leak. Days ago, I spent an entire hour.
Your job is to distract the enemy.
An entire hour.
Raids the ship for much needed supplies.
Make using Necros Prime and the resource boosters.
Hold up. Detecting glass resonance. It's close.
They have just shut down.
In that hour,
I'm sending life support as your way.
Drop rate should have increased with enemy level. Alongside me telling you it should increase with master rank. Reward gains for effort. Otherwise, what's the point in playing any more than 5 minutes in a survival or 5 waves in a defense other than mastery rank experience for people who are still working on that? It's really boring for me spending so long in these missions, not getting what I'm after. I do have the time to spare to spend a few hours in one mission. For the vast majority of people playing this game, they don't have that time. Neither do they have that patience. trying to remember how long total I've spent going after this one particular monoguard. And edit fast. 4 or 5 days. It's been about 25 to 30 minutes each time. Minimum of 5 hours of total mission time that I can remember right now. I have no idea how many of those things I've killed. This place is not sacred. Your Messiah complex is most unbecoming.
Only I, Thor, know the true power of the void. It is time.
There you are, Mr. Half-Man. Or should I say half-clone? Mr. Vorgasm, please shut the fuck up.
This death is temporary. My existence is forever. I cannot be.
Don't break your arm jerking yourself off, Mr. Vorgasm. In the Night Watch napalm spread. Stop shooting at me! AoE. Continuously damages it, so it keeps it from growing back at all.
This bounty out as long as you can.
Another one. You, huh? Fuck off. Fucking bombard. Another asshole over there. Fuck off. I remember when I used to think killing more in this area was hard. I'm so glad that I view it easier now. Kinda curious if that's gonna happen. I think I'm data mining the game after well over 30 years of actually playing games, and then a brief stint exploring, actually writing code for myself. I have the knowledge and the capacity to actually notice what game mechanics are going on. There's no hacking necessary. I just know, because I've trained myself to taking the time to learn. Because at one point, I was actually going to go to Full Sail online courses and learn as much as I could about programming for video games. Shit. Right, that one's spaghettified. drone. Get down from there. You're gonna hurt yourself. See what I tell you? You exploded. Yeah, you say that, but I don't really see the mod card I'm after dropping now, do I? Now, the higher the enemy levels go, the more damage they do. Meanwhile, my health, armor, and shield pool doesn't increase to match. So adaptation should have provided a percentage increase of damage resistance. Realistically, it's gonna be a few. Why doesn't he suffer knockback from being so close to his own weapon's projectile exploding? Where's the equity in that? Where's the balance in that? Where is it? Did you shove it up your ass? Anybody want to tell me what the player can do that bounces projectiles right back at the enemy that's passive that you only turn on and leave on? Not seeing any equitable balance there, are we?
Yeah.
options that leaves us with is to just meta it all up and do absurd amounts of damage. Walking up behind me. Out front, where I can see you all plainly. Line up, one at a time. I'll blow you all to bits. Okay, you leave me no choice. Minions, assemble! Tested that idea before. Why doesn't that continuous dot affect the nullifier shield? Seriously, where's the equity in that? Thank you.
successful we will be.
Right, I'm gonna call that one at 30. 25. Initially, I estimated I would be at this for months trying to get that one mod card. The longer I go at it, the more it looks like I'm right. It shouldn't take months not to get something like this. Oh, while I'm on the subject of months, those login rewards that periodically come in, looks like they come in every 100 or every 50 login days. That should be every week or every month. Instead of every 100 or every 50 days. It should be a lot more frequent. You want people to enjoy playing the game, don't you? Well, Microsoft, the more people enjoy playing the game, the more willing they are to spend money for the microtransactions. But then again, money is about to become a non-concern for you. Along with everyone on the planet. Humanity's about to destroy itself, everyone. Whether you agree or not. Whether you believe it or not.
Busy while a fellow operative raids the ship for supplies.
Mm.
Ready?
Might need to have something.
Trigger the alarm. Life supports and cut off. They're trying to choke you out. Hold on. I'm sending auxiliary life support.
Stop running away from me. You'll just die tired. Need an overabundance of, nor can anyone use an overabundance of. Not unless all you do is just sit on all the blueprints you need until you just go and farm a bunch of argon crystals. Which is pointless. Once you start something to be fabricating, you can leave it in the fabricator. You have space to pick it up. In that way, as long as I've been playing Warfucking. piece of candy. Seriously, I can't put 100 Argon Crystals to use. Even if I did have enough credits, and even if I weren't gathering them for the Tenocon thing. The wait timer on the foundry fabricating things is absurd in itself. By the time I had made, I don't know, between 3 and 5 of anything required Argon Crystals, would already be deteriorating. Shift my tactics and just go until I fight and destroy half of the orgasm guy and keep repeating the process and build up a massive stockpile of the toxic status mods and then trade those off to people who need them. Since it's gonna take months to get the mod card I'm after, why not? Look, Mr. Vorgasm, I don't care about your anus key. Just shut up and die already.
If the general wants true salvation, they will lay down their arms and wait for the baptism.
Now, I'll lay something down on you. How do you like that?
Cut in half, destroyed, but through its Yannis key, the void held through. It brought me here, and here I was reborn. This death is temporary. My existence is forever. I cannot be destroyed.
Let me close, dickhead. Don't hear me rambling on about it every time I encounter someone. work until I get to half of ore. Definitely more beneficial. I'll get those mods out of it. Look, you slight lip. Let me by! Bastard. Fucking Oregon, designing shit that makes people not able to jump out of a hole. Fuck you! Come on, load up. You can do it. Seen you do it a million times before. Not literally, but close enough. At this point, I really do wish we could trade argon crystals. Having nearly 100 of them is not my cup of tea right now. Hell, it's not even my pot of coffee. It's not my hot cocoa. It's not even my alcoholic beverage of choice right now. It's none of it.
Your job is to just... enemy while a fellow Tenno operative raids the ship for much needed supplies. Make your presence known.
Curiously,
I have just shut down all systems.
Why not add the option? Your way. The optional mechanic in a survival to have between 1 and 3 go in and do this bit, and between 1 and 3 go off and do the actual raiding for supplies. Instead of this, well, in conjunction with the option to just wait for every 5 minutes as something drop. Why not? Definitely would add an extra level of intricacy and maybe even difficulty for hard and ultra hard mode like they're talking about. I didn't want to pick that up right now, but fuck it, why not? Multitasking and such. Toe, look, more fuck gone crystals. missed him. Not until I get the half guy. Come on, Gorgasm. Show your ugly half a face. I would call you a halfling, but I would offend the hobbits. One-shot a corrupt heavy gunner. He hit the wall.
Behold the Tendo. Come to scavenge and desecrate this sacred...
Scavenge? No. Not scavenging when I have to kill you to get what I'm after. Desecrate?
Tendo,
if you think me killing you is desecrating things, whatever, dude.
I, for, know the true power of the void.
Was gonna shoot the other guys, but you popped up right in front of me.
I will teach these trespassers the redemptive power of my gathered teeth. The real world is
single.
Let it be known, if the Tenno wants true salvation, Then we'll lay down their arms and wait for the baptism of my Yannis key.
Dude, I don't want something that you call an anus key, okay? There's no telling what part of you it was plugged into, okay? You've got a gaping gap where your guts used to be. I don't want to know how many holes you've plugged that thing into, okay?
I am energy, and I cannot be destroyed.
Shut up, half of war. Chasm. Of these to sell off to people. Have to use the restroom. I'll be back. Brownies. What the hell? You mean to tell me it's raining outside? Yes, yes you do. Interesting. I wasn't expecting the rain right now. Alrighty. Wash, rinse, dry, and repeat until... Well, in my case, I'm gonna be severely drunk. It's a nice alternative to excruciating boredom.
Hey,
A lone Tenno operative is raiding the ship for supplies. You are here to distract the enemy. Trigger the... They have just shut down all systems. Life support capsules your way.
Oh, look, more fucking Argon. With a fucking hole where his guts used to be, I don't think he should be saying anything about purity. Especially a clone.
It is time. I will teach these trespassers the redemptive power of my goddess. They will be. We cannot blame these creatures. They are being led by a false prophet, an imposter who knows not the secrets of the void.
Or, first of all, no one ever claimed to be a prophet. Your messiah complex is most unbecoming. Please shut the fuck up.
And here I was reborn. This death is temporary. My existence is forever. I cannot be destroyed.
Au contraire, you ever heard of deleting a file?
When you are ready.
Same deal, jackass. Oh, look! More fucking Argon crystals! All this nonsense, and I'm only after coolant leak. Problems worse than just its exceedingly and excessively low 0.02% drop rate. Problem is worse than that.
A lone Tenno operative is raiding his ship for supplies. You are here to distract the enemy. Trigger the alarm.
The thing you have to kill in order to have it drop doesn't spawn in very frequently at all.
They have just shut down all systems. I'm sending life support capsules your way.
I think I'll come back here with Helios sometime and just get excessive scans of everything. two for one. Hey, get back here! Jackass. Fucking grapple me right in when I'm in front of you. Fuck off. I was annoyed the very first time Vor said that. Blah blah blah. Look, Mr. Cut in Half, shut up. Hey, there's another joke I can use. He's half the man I am. I'm just gonna beat you with my stick. How does that feel to you, huh? Here, just suck it, half fuck.
Let it be known, if the general wants true salvation, they will lay down their arms and wait for the baptism of my Yannis King.
I know what he means when he says arms, but I can't help but think he means literally our fucking arms. I mean, he is half a man. I wouldn't put it past him to make that sort of arrangement with taking your arms off. Especially considering the Ganir are all clones and they just lop body parts off and replace them with mechanical ones. I really wouldn't put it past him. I did not intend on getting up here. Oh, wait. Says me.
job is to distract the enemy while a fellow Tenno operative raids the ship for much needed supplies. Make your presence known. They have just shut down all systems. I'm sending life support capsules your way.
Stick it in a pipe and smoke it. You know what? Argon crystals, crystal meth, it's not that much of a stretch. I'll just run a secret Warframe Argon ring of drug running and musings. Kinda like how that one other YouTuber does smoke knitting extract. Yeah, he can smoke knitting extract, and I'll just snort fucking argon. Fuck it! Anybody else want some pink powder? Better snort it quickly, it'll evaporate. Argon in its natural state is usually a gas. At that point, I could just stick it to an inhaler. Definitely some interesting ways to use argon here. Listen, you little fucking pop frog monkey! I jumped over the other side of that cold patch to kill you, and you jump over. Fuck off! I blame the Argon for this. They're smoking or inhaling way too much of it. That and knitting extract. That's why we don't get so much of it anymore. These corrupt assholes are smoking all of it. Stop shooting at me. It's not helping you kill me. Oh, fuck yeah, thunder now. Big torrent of rain followed by thunder. You can definitely tell that's a summertime storm. Stop running, you're just gonna die tired. And now you and Four have something in common. You're both half the men you used to be. I have disarmed him. Literally, there's his arm right there. I don't think that's what Thor meant when he said that, but, you know, I'll disarm his crew for him. At least I can do. Oh, fuck yeah. Who would have thought converting Forma into a fucking smoke hole would be so fucking cool? And give such a buzz. Something to smoke. I mean, at that, we'd have protein-based technology. Theoretical protein technology. Matter to energy conversion tech. You know, the thing that, Einstein's energy mass conversion theorem is based on. You don't think he got that idea by himself, do you? Hitting the ground, it disappeared. Never mind. I'll tell you, hitting the ground is no way to get me to go away. See? Little gunner, you know, hitting the ground doesn't work. I just hit you harder than you hit the ground. Jumping over things! Just making me chase you. And shoost I shall. Everywhere they can jump over something. Like that one did. Yep, I was right to target the things they jump over instead of them specifically. I don't think they jump over stairs, but I certainly do. Oops, missed my mark. Just go over here. Channel them into this narrow corridor where their great false numbers we've kept for shit. Thanks, man. This really helped out. I mean, it's obvious, but it really does.
Hey! Stop knocking my metal body around, you fuck!
The only thing you're accomplishing is agitating me. Oh, fuck you, gnarly bitch. Oh, fuck you, I got crystals. Smoke you later. Never mind. Orgasm has appeared. Pokemon battle commands. Four used bore opponent to death technique. It's super ineffective.
Look what our Tenno operative just found. They could not do this without you.
Donna uses fuck you for technique. It's mildly more effective than being annoyed to death. Now for the teabagging. Fuck you. Bite my necrotic ass.
And wait for the baptism of my Yannis key.
Oh dear god, he's talking about his anus key again.
But I, Vor, will cleanse this place of their impurity.
How are you gonna do that? By boring me until I leave? That would be most efficient. In fact, it seems to be working right now. I don't have to listen to him talk no more during the rest of this mission. Life's really picking up out there with thunder and whatnot. Yeah, 118 minutes. It's almost been 2 hours. If anybody manages to watch all of this, god damn, you must be more bored than I am. Well, till next time, fuck off.